Hello everyone, in this video I will explain how to implement hierarchical clustering using the customer's dataset. Now let me show you the CSV file which we will be using. So this is the dataset which we will be using. This is the dataset of the customers who regularly visit the mall and they buy a particular product. So we have five columns over here: customer ID, genre, age, annual income, and spending score. Spending score shows how much they spend on a particular product or how much products they buy from the mall. So now, coming to the coding part. So this is the code for that. We have done the coding on PyCharm. Now let's first understand what is hierarchical clustering. So in hierarchical clustering, we build a cluster tree, that is dendrogram, to represent data where each group or node links to two or more successor groups. The groups are nested and organized as a tree. Now you can see over here B, A, B, C, all these are nodes, all the dots represents the nodes, and all the dots are linked to a single cluster, like BC represents a single cluster, and A, B, C are nested in a single cluster. Here also E, F are linked in a single cluster, D, E, F again constitute a single cluster. Here is the tree which we have got. This is also known as dendrogram. I will be showing you the output. The output actually looks like this tree. Now let me show you the output first. So this is the dendrogram which I have explained right now. I will be explaining more about this later on. These are the cluster groups. So now coming to the coding part. First of all, we need to import some libraries, Python libraries, and for that we need to install these libraries like matplotlib for plotting the graphs, pandas for importing the data set. So now finally, we have imported the libraries here, and now we are importing the data set mall, that is mall customers, using pd.read.csv. Here in this line of code, actually represents CRT and 4. It actually represents the annual income and spending score values. I have already shown you. These two columns. Now moving further, we are using the dendrogram to find the optimal number of clusters. Here I have already shown you the output. Here we are using Euclidean distance. Euclidean distance show the vertical lines in the dendrograms. This is the distance between the clusters. Like, let me show you once again. These vertical lines are the Euclidean distances. We calculate the Euclidean distances, like the parallel line to the customers. Like, let's come into the blue line. This is the Euclidean distance from here to here for this particular customer. So we have plotted the graph between customers and Euclidean distances, that is dendrogram. We have actually plotted dendrogram, and we have imported And here is the code for dendrogram, which we have used. We have imported the library for that, SciPy library. Now we are fitting the hierarchical clustering to the data set. We are now predicting how much customers are actually interested in buying the product according to their annual income. So we can see the output as so this is the output. Finally, we are predicting the output. This is the output which we have predicted. Now I will explain you about this matrix from below code. Now here we have plotted the graph for the customers who comes in a single cluster, in different clusters actually. Here in this code, here we have predicted the, this is the y value, this is the y hyphen underscore hc values which we have printed before, and this is the output for that. So it 0 represents the cluster 1, customers who come in cluster 1, and it is represented by red dots. I will be showing you the output afterwards. And cluster 2 is represented by blue dots. Cluster 3 is represented by green dots. Cluster 4 is represented by cyan color. Cluster 5 is represented by magenta dots. And here is the YHC values which we have printed. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 for all the clusters. So we have already seen the data set, and according to that data set we have and the predictions which we have got, we have numbered all the customers according to that, like 4 for the customer which come under cluster 5 has got the value 4. The customer which comes under cluster 4 has got the value 3, like 3 shows the customer who comes in value 4 in cluster 4. Now let's have a look on the output again. This is the dendrogram. So see, I have already explained the list of customers, and these are the clusters which we have formed. So red color displays the cluster 1, cluster 2 is displayed in blue color. So basically from this graph, the more people will basically consider the customers with cyan color or green color. Like they will basically focus on the customers who comes in cluster 3 and cluster 4. So, thank you so much.